Let's discuss the three main male accessory sex glands. But first, let's talk about what the term accessory sex glands means. Basically, accessory just indicates that we're not talking about the gonads, we're not talking about the testes. And so these aren't going to play a role in terms of the formation of sperm, but they will play a role in terms of the formation of seminal fluid. And we'll talk about specifically what these are composed of. So let's talk about the most proximal of these glands, and this is going to be those seminal vesicles. So let's locate them first. You can see right here, this is your bladder. Right here, this is the prostate, so it's going to be more superior to the prostate and at the base of the posterior portion of the urinary bladder. Now, as you can see here, this is going to actually compose a big portion of, or a big volume in terms of the semen. And this is particularly important because it's going to secrete what we refer to as alkaline fluid. If you think about semen, if you think about the urinary pathway, as well as the female reproductive system, this is going to have a very acidic environment. And since this is composed of an alkaline fluid, that can really play a role in terms of protecting the semen in these acidic environments as well. And one way by which it does this, there's fructose associated with the seminal fluid. So it makes sense in terms of the name. You have seminal, this is going to form the biggest portion in terms of volume of the semen. Now, as we move inferiorly, you have the prostate here. As I mentioned before, this is about the size of a ping pong ball. It's going to be inferior to the urinary bladder. And as we discussed in terms of our male urethra PowerPoint, this is going to be surrounded by that prostatic urethra. And it is within this prostatic urethra that you're going to have the secretion and the dumping of not only the sperm, but the rest of that seminal fluid associated with the seminal vesicles. Now, unlike what we had in terms of the seminal glands, we're going to have a slightly acidic fluid that's going to be secreted by the prostate. It is going to have a milky-like appearance, so a kind of white appearance associated with the prostate. And this is going to have citric acid. And that's going to play a role in terms of helping with the production of ATP that you would need in terms of the sperm associated with semen. Now, if you've heard of some of these accessory sex glands, prostate often comes up, particularly in terms of when we're talking about pathology. Prostate cancer is now the most frequent cause of death in males from cancer. It surpassed lung cancer in the early 1990s. Prostate cancer is much more frequent in older individuals, and this is different than prostatitis. A lot of times you hear this term used interchangeably with an enlarged prostate. It's not necessarily the same thing as that. You can have an enlarged prostate with prostatitis. You can have other issues in terms of it really constricting the urethral orifice portion. You know how we have that prostatic urethra. So that can cause painful or frequent urination that can occur in males. The smallest in terms of these accessory sex glands is your bulbo-urethral glands. And these are going to be paired. These are inferior to the prostate and lateral to the membranous urethra. So you don't really see them in this particular image here. These are going to specifically drain into the spongy urethra, and this will happen. These will secrete fluid caused by sexual arousal. So the innervation, the sensory innervation will lead to the secretion of just this alkaline fluid and mucus that helps in terms of forming kind of a lubricant function in terms of these glands. So you can see in terms of that, the glands that we're discussing here, you'll have your prostate right here. Your seminal vesicles are about in this region here. Both of those glands are going to drain into the prostatic urethra, whereas your bulbo-urethral glands are going to drain into the membranous urethra, and then all of that fluid will eventually travel through the spongy urethra and exit through the external urethral meatus.